And if I was wanting to put it in a succinct phrase, I would say that citizenship is about caring for your neighbour. Basically, it's about the internal substance of society rather than the external formalities. In popular terms, you could call it community spirit. In philosophical terms, you might be talking about the social contract. But it's very much to do with the relations between people in communities. In practice, I think that works out in a multi-layered sort of way. At a sort of base level, there's what you might call everyday citizenship, which is the daily local interaction of people, which is basically simply a matter of good neighbourliness. Looking out for your neighbours, looking out for the street that you live in, making sure that that is a street, a locality, which is good to live in. It's clean, it's quiet, it's safe. And in many respects, India, that is absolutely fundamental to civilised society. The state doesn't keep our streets clean and quiet and safe. It's the people who live there who keep them clean and quiet and safe. And they do so because the people who live there care about the other people who live in the same street. So that's, if you like, the sort of baseline, which, you know, I would say, you know, most people who put their hands up just now, participate in. Then sort of above that, you might identify an area of active citizenship where you do a bit more than just looking after your neighbour. You actually, every now and then, at a weekend or whatever, you get up, you get involved in some voluntary activity, maybe clearing up some wasteland or doing some good works for the isolated elderly, or getting involved in youth groups and so on and so forth. These, if you like, are your active citizens who do a little bit more than just the baseline of everyday citizenship. And then at a third tier, there's what you might call a committed citizen. And those are the people who actually put in an awful lot of time in actually organising the cleanups, organising community associations, neighbourhood associations, spending a lot of time getting engaged in planning applications, maybe volunteering as school governors and so on and so forth. Your committed citizen puts in a hell of a lot of time, and the state benefits from them enormously. So the question I want to take back then is, given this notion of citizenship and these types of citizenship, can students be good citizens? And from my perspective, as a resident in a university town, I would say that this is a much more problematic issue than is sometimes seen to be. It's actually very difficult for students to be what I call committed citizens, simply because the students are there on a temporary basis. You can't actually get involved in organising and running a residence association or a community association, because that simply takes a lot of time. One of the activities that I'm involved in is producing this, which is what's called a neighbourhood design statement. It's one of the major activities that my community is involved in. We've been 5 years on this. There's a group of half a dozen of us running it. Students, we've been through several generations of students, several cohorts of students whilst we've been doing this. So students can't act as students at level. As active students, however, the sort of middle level, what I was talking about, I think it's very clear that students do put an awful lot of effort into volunteering. And I'm looking forward to reading through this and seeing an analysis of it. What I was looking for, just skimming through just now, was the sort of comparisons between the level of volunteering amongst students and other age groups in the population. I did read somewhere, I can't remember where enough I read it now, that student volunteering was above average, if you took an average of volunteering across the whole population. It was also above average in retired people, like myself. Partly that's because students and retired people have more opportunities to do so than if you've got a family and you've been working hard to look after them and so on and so forth. But you know, that shouldn't detract from the fact that students do a lot of volunteering. And I know that we have a problem in our neighbourhood of isolation of the elderly, and students do an awful lot of good work in that area in visiting and looking after elderly residents. It's when you come down to the bottom level of everyday citizenship that the problems actually emerge. I don't want to say that this is true of all students, but it's very true of the phenomenon of studentification, which is a very widespread phenomenon in this country now and has developed over the last 10 years, whereby it's not the case for all students, but the majority of students who go away to university tend to live in what you might call student colonies. We certainly have them in Leeds, and Susan will know all about those as an inhabitant of they have them in Nottingham, Manchester, Newcastle, Southampton. Any university town tends to have its student colony. And one of the characteristics of the student colony is you obviously have a very high turnover. What this means is that the students who live in those colonies don't know their neighbours. So it's very difficult to pursue good neighbourliness. We know this because the Unipol student home has done surveys of students and found that most students don't know their neighbours. That in itself is unfortunate, but one of the consequences of this is that without a sense of neighbourliness, you actually get developing a very destructive ethos in these areas. And this is the significance of studentification. Crime rates are high, not because students commit crime, but because students are very unaware of safety issues and very vulnerable to crime. But this affects everybody else who lives in the area. The part of Leeds that I live in is 72 streets in which the majority of the residents are students. It's the most squalid part of the whole city. We have a resort economy, it's takeaways, pubs, off licences and so on. Many of my neighbours would say that students are effectively in these areas, not citizens at all, but anti-citizens. I don't want to say this is not students per se. Anti-citizenship in this sense arises from the fact, first of all, that you've got concentrations of single type of group of people in a very enclosed area, and secondly, these are concentrations of people with a very high turnover. So in university towns you get this with students, in seaside towns you get it with seasonal workers and benefit claimants, in market towns you get it with migrant workers. So you know, it's a phenomenon of student colonies in university towns, but it's not peculiar to that area. In actual fact, nationally the problem is so bad that the government is bringing in new legislation, student coming in April, so that councils, like Munt Council, can prevent any further concentrations of shared homes, which are the root of this problem. So that's my answer to the question, can students be good citizens? Yes, they can. Unfortunately, an awful lot of the time, they are not.